Hi. Today we'll start with the sequencing chapter. Here the name itself indicates that we have to sequence the job in a right order to get the minimum processing time or total lapse time. Okay, this is the main aim of the sequencing chapter. Okay, here before going to the problems, first we'll go for the some terminologies in the sequencing. First terminology is number of machines. Number of machines means how many resources available in our machines. Say suppose 1 or 2 or 3 like that. That is the number of machines or number of facilities available in our area. Okay, that is the regarding the number of machines. Next one is the processing time. Processing time means to complete the one job, how much time it will take. That is the processing time. Next one is processing order. Processing order means what is the first job and what is the next job. That is regarding the processing order. This is regarding the processing order. Next one is the idle time of machine. Idle time of machine means when there is no job to perform the in that machine, then we are calling that one as the idle time of machine. Next, total elapsed time means suppose we will consider the two machines. In that two machines, if you give the first job to the first machine, then you complete the last job in the second machine, and whatever total time it will take, we are calling that one as the total elapsed time. Okay, these are the terminologies we are using in the sequencing problem. Okay, let us go through the one problem. And here we are having the different cases, that is n jobs 2 machines and n jobs 3 machines, n jobs m number of machines. But out of these one, first we will start with the n jobs 2 machines. N job 2 machine means here we are having the total 6 jobs are there, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And here we are having the one turning machine and another one is the threading machine, that is machine A and machine B. Okay, to complete the job 1, on machine A it will take 3 hours, okay. On machine 2 it will take 8 hours. Like that, here they have given the total 6 jobs and here we are having the 2 machines, okay. Before going to the what is the sequence, first we will understand the how to make the sequence. See here we are having the processing times. These all the type processing times are in hours. First we have to see these processing times here. In out of this processing time, which is the least processing time? Okay, we have to see. Okay, in the first machine we are having the 3, 12, 5, 2, 9, 11. These are the processing times. And in machine B we are having the 8, 10, 9, 6, 3, 1. These are the processing times we are having. Okay, total in these two machines, the least processing time is on machine B. That is for the job 6. Okay, here we have to understand the two things. If the least processing time is on machine A, then we have to place that job towards left side. If the least processing time on the machine B, then we have to place that job in the last or towards right side. This is the one thing we have to remember. Okay, if the least processing time is on the machine A, then we have to place the job towards left side, left end. And if the least processing time on the machine B, then we have to place that job at the right side of the things. Here the least processing time is on the machine B. Hence, we have to place the job 6 at the right side. Then here we can make the one, because we already placed this 6th job, hence you can make the one circle here. Okay. Next, out of these again remaining processing time, which is the least processing time? Least processing time is again next 2. 2 is on which machine? Machine A. And job is 4. Hence, we have to place the job 4 at the left end of the sequencing. Okay, this one is the first one because here I have written the 6. This is the second one. Here I have written the 4. Hence, here you can make this one as enclosed on the oval. Okay, and the next least processing time is 3. That is on machine A is also 3 is there and machine B is also 3 is there. Okay, hence what we have to do, you can select the first for A machine, that is the job 1, I will write here job 1. For B machine, job 5, I will write towards right side, job 5. Here also you can make these two are already completed, hence you can draw that here. Next least processing time is, that is 5. 5 is on machine A for the job 3. Okay, hence we have to write after the one or left side. Okay, and finally we are left with the two. You can write the two here. Okay, now we have got the sequencing as 4 1 3 2 5 6. This is the sequence we have got. Okay, suppose instead of doing the sequencing like this, if you go for the job 1 first, job 2 next, job 3, job 4, job 5, job 6, then the total elapsed time is more. Okay, if you go for this sequencing, then we can reduce the elapsed time. That is the main intention of this N jobs 2 machines. Here we are using the Johnson's rule for to write this sequencing. Okay, next I will write this same sequence in the another table. Okay, this is the first, they have given the one table, and the next here we have write the sequence. After writing the sequence, next we have write the one more table. In this table, first column is we have write the job. Okay, and second column is machine A in and out. Okay, and third column is machine B in and out. Okay, here I will write the whatever sequence we have got, I will write the same sequence here. That is 4, 1, 3, 2, 5, and final 6. Okay, I have written the whatever sequence I have got here, I have written the same sequence here. Okay, next, by default, for the machine A, we have to take in time as 0. We have to take the in time as 0. Okay, next, for this 0, for the job 4, what is the processing time? We are having the processing time as 2. Okay, 0 plus 2 is 2. That will become the out time for the machine A for job 4. Okay, next, for the job 1, we have to take this out time for the this 4 job is there. We have to take this time as the in time for the machine, job 1. I will write here 2. Okay, and what is the processing time for the job 1? That is 3. Processing time for the job 1 is 3. 2 plus 3 is 5. We have written the 5 here. Again, we have to take this number as it is here. That is for the 3, job 3. That is 5. Okay. For job 3, what is the processing time? 5. 5 plus 5 is 10. 5 plus 5 is 10. Okay. Next, again, we have to take this 10 as it is here for job 2. Okay. For job 2, what is the processing time? Processing time for job 2, machine A, processing time is 12. 10 plus 12 is 22. 10 plus 12 is 22. Next, you have to write the 22 as it is here. 22. Next, job is 5. For job 5, what is the processing time? 9. 22 plus 9 is 31. You can write the 31 here. 31. Next, you can write the 31 as it is here in the last row. Okay, and for the 6th job, what is the processing time? 11 is it. 31 plus 11 is 42. I will write that value here. That is the 42. This is for the machine A in and out time. Okay, similarly, we have to write the machine B in and out times. To write the machine B in and out time, for the first row, whatever the out time for the machine A is there, okay, we have to take that is the in time for the machine B. Okay, hence I will write the machine B in time is 2. Okay, for job number 4, what is the processing time? 6. Okay, 6 plus 2. 6 plus 2 means 8. 6 plus 2 means 8. To complete the job 4, it will take 8 minutes. Okay, in time is 2 and out time is 8. Okay, when again we have to write this time as it is here, and here we have to be very careful while writing this time. If this, suppose this value is more than this value, then we have to write this value as it is here. Okay, suppose if this value is more than this one, we have to write this value as it is here. Okay, if here this value is, this is the 8 and this one is 5, hence I will write this 8 as it is here. Okay, next, for the job 1, for the machine B, what is the time we are having? 8. 8 plus 8 is 16. 8 plus 8 is 16. Okay. Next, again, we have to see these two numbers. This one is 10 and this is 16. And hence, we have to write the value as 16 itself. Okay. Next, for the third job, what is the time we are having? 9. 16 plus 9 is 25. 16 plus 9 is 25. Okay, here again 25, this is 22. Hence, we have write the 22 only. Which value is more? We have write the that value. Sorry. This is 25. We have write. Okay. Next, for the job 2. For the job 2, we are having the processing time as 10. 25 plus 10 is 35. This is 35. Again, we have write the here time as 35. Okay. Next job is 5. That is, for the fifth job, processing time is 3. 35 plus 3 is 38. See here the time is 42 and here the time is 38. But we should not write 38 here, but we have write the 42. Hence, I will write the 42 here. Okay, 42 as it is. Next thing is, for the sixth job and the processing time is 1. Hence, I will write the 42 plus 1 is 43. Okay, this is regarding the how to write the first. This is the job. Job means whatever the sequence you have got, you have write that one as it is. And next one is machine A in and out and machine B in and out. In all the cases, we have written the this value. But at the last, what I have done, here we have got the 38, but I have written the 42. Okay, that must be very careful while writing the this in value. Okay, for the machine B or the subsequent machines. Okay, this is regarding the this calculations. Okay, first they will give the table. Okay, and we have to write the sequence. After that, we have to find out the total elapsed time. Here the total elapsed time is 43 hours. Okay, in this problem, total elapsed time is equal to 43 hours. Okay, next we have to find out the idle time for machine A and idle time for machine B. To find out the idle time for machine A and idle time for machine B, what we have to do, we have to calculate the what is the total processing time for the machine A and machine B. Okay, just we will add the these values. 12 plus 3 is 15, 20, 22, 31, 42. Total processing time for the machine A is 42 hours. Okay, and the total processing time for the machine B is 18, 27, 33, 36, 37 hours. Okay, next we have to find out the idle time on machine A. Okay, that is idle time on machine A is equal to total elapsed time, that is total elapsed time is 43 hours minus and the total processing time on machine A, that is 42 hours. Then we will get the idle time as 1 hour. Okay, for the machine A. Similarly, we have to calculate the idle time for machine B. That is idle time on machine B is equal to, that is total elapsed time, that is 43 minus 37. That is equal to 43 minus 37 is equal to 6 hours. This is the sequencing problem on the n jobs two machines. Just I will once again I will glance the all these things. First thing is they will give the total number of jobs, two machines, machine A and machine B, and for this we have to find out the sequence. How we have to find out the sequence? First we have to write the total number of box depending upon the jobs, and we have to see the least processing time. If the least processing time on the machine A, then we have to write towards left side. If the least processing time on the machine B, then we have to write towards the right side. Okay, similarly we have to calculate for the all the jobs. Then we have got the sequencing as 4 1 3 2 5 6. We have to write that sequencing in the another table, that is job. Okay, next, for the machine A in and out time. Initially we have to take the in value as 0. And according to the your jobs, we have to add the processing times. Then we will get the out time for the machine A. Again, for the next job, we have to take that out time for that second one as the in time. Again, we have to add that processing time. Then finally, we will get that for machine 1. Okay. Similarly, we have to go for the machine 2. For machine 2, to write the in time, we have to take the out time for the machine A, first value. Whatever the first value is there, we will take that one as the in time for the machine B. And we have to add the next processing time. Then we will get the out time for that particular job. And while writing these two numbers, we have to see this number and this number. Okay, which one is higher? We have to write that value here. Okay, and finally, we have got the value as 43. That 43 itself indicates the total elapsed time for that to process the 6 jobs. Okay, next thing is idle time on machine A. To calculate the idle time on machine A, total elapsed time minus processing time on machine A. Okay, that is 42. 43 minus 42 is 1 hour. Okay, next idle time on machine B is, that is 43 minus 37. 37 is the processing time on machine B. Okay, like this, we have to calculate the total elapsed time. First thing is sequence, next one is total elapsed time, and idle time on different machines. This is regarding the n jobs, 2 machines.